This is what DNA looks like. Discovered in 1953 by four scientists, James Watson, Francis Crick, Rosalind Franklin, and Morris Wilkins, DNA is essentially the code that tells our bodies how to develop and function. DNA is found in the cells of all living things, such as trees, plants, animals, as well as us humans. All humans are made up of trillions of tiny building blocks, known as cells. And at the nucleus of each of these cells are DNA molecules. We have discovered many useful and complex things about DNA that can be applied to forensics, medicine, agriculture, and genealogy, as well as many other fields. However, there is still much to discover in the field of DNA. For example, over 98% of the human genome is non-coding, which we know very little about. In order to conduct any research on DNA, we must first extract it from cells. It is a very simple process that can be done with household items. Let's take a banana as an example. First, scientists must mash up the banana to separate its cells. A salt solution is added to separate them further. However, we only need the banana cells. The solution is cleared of any unseparated cells or fibers using filter paper or a centrifuge. To access the DNA within a cell, we must remove the protective layers of the cell in the nucleus called membranes. These fat molecules can be dissolved by the chemical property of liquid soap. After adding the soap, the membranes are disrupted and the DNA is freed. We have removed the DNA from the cells, but it isn't visible as it remains dissolved in the salt solution, much like salt in water or sugar in tea. Ethanol, a type of alcohol, is added to the solution. DNA is insoluble in ethanol, and it floats back to the top of the solution. To recap, firstly the banana is mashed up and a salt solution is added. Then the solution is filtered. Soap is added to release the DNA from the cell. Lastly, ethanol is added so that the DNA can be collected at the top of the solution. This principle can be used for any other cells containing DNA.